Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to give a demo of IC tester. This is a universal IC tester in which a range of different ICs are given. You can test the all different type of ICs whether they are working or not with this IC tester. And you can also use this IC tester as a frequency counter. It also gives the features to count the frequency of any required frequencies. So this is our universal IC tester. The order code for this universal IC tester is 68027. This is a digital IC tester. You can use this order code to check the specs about this by visiting our website, which is www.tesca.in. So this comes with a 9 volt DC adapter, and it also has a inbuilt battery feature. The battery right now reverse to do consume the battery, and this is have the LCD screen of 16:2 digital LCD screen, and this will give the different information about this. And this is the GIF pin IC placing compartment in which you can place the ICs from 1 to 28 pin of ICs, and this is the stand to lock the ICs while testing. And this have a clear mode, find and test button. Test buttons are two of test button. You can use any either of the test button to working with. And these are the 9 different hexadecimal keys to provide the different codes of ICs, and the next key to check the next device whichever it used. And this is the automatic IC finding device button. By connecting the IC, if you do not know the IC number or IC device, press the find button. It will auto find the device. If the device is working, this will show on the LCD screen as well. And the mode button will change the IC tester to frequency counter. When you press the mode button, this will change the IC tester to frequency counter. And by connecting this BNC cable on this upper terminal of this IC tester, you will get the frequency whatever you want to check. And the clear button can be working in the back mode, and as well as you enter the device address or device number, this will be can be cleared by this. So we are also giving a user manual, and there is a stand in this. You can easily place this IC tester while working with. So this is all about the description of IC tester, and we are also offering a user manual in which all the details and working of different functions are provided, and range of the IC tester in which the different ICs that has been in used can be provided. So all different ranges ICs, I will test the different ICs for this demo of this IC tester. So now we are going to give the demo. For this, we will connect the adapter of 9 volt on this adapter pin presented over here, and this AC adapter will be connected to any AC power source. And as we connect the AC power source, the IC tester will start. This is now asking for device number. So whatever the IC you have to enter the device number and you can start this. So for testing, we have a IC 7400. So we'll place this IC by starting the number starting pin 1 from this end to 28 from this end. So this is IC that I have placed here and log this by this GIF sockets. So now to find this IC automatically, we'll just press find, and in some time it will automatically detect the IC, and the IC device number will be shown on the LCD screen. Here you can see it has auto find the device. The IC that I have inserted in this was 7400, and it is clearly showing us that the device number is 7400. If you find the device is not correct, you can press next and match the number following as per this. So These are the related IC nearby IC numbers, nearby functioning ICs of this IC tester. So this will give you different IC numbers as well. So this is the on off switch here. We will off this IC tester again and then on. And to test the IC, just press the IC number 7400 that I have inserted and press test. And this is showing us that the test is passed. Again we will test this and test passed. So IC is good, IC is working. Now for testing the faulty IC, I am inserting an IC. This is the faulty IC that I have in using. So this is the 74163 IC. So I will lock this and again clear this device number and press 74163, the IC number or the device number of my IC, and press test. After testing, it is showing that the IC is faulty and this is showing that the test is failed. And for auto finding this device, if I press the auto find, this will also not find the IC. Or in case it find the IC number, then you have to test the IC again to check it whether it is working or not. So if this does not find the IC, the auto search over will be shown on the LCD screen. In some time, this will give us the signal search over. It do not able to find the IC if the IC is faulty. Here you can see search over signal is given and the IC is not found by this IC device. Now for different range of ICs, the range are given in the user manual. So these are the digital ICs from TTL400 series and TTL740 series that I tested right now, and TTL451 and different series 45 series. So we will test IC one of both the range. 7400 I have tested from 740 range. Now I will place an IC again, and this is the 4011 IC. So we'll place this 4011 IC. This is from the TTL40 series and press find. This will take a time, and after some time it will search and show the IC number on the LCD screen. Here you can see this is showing the 4011 IC. Now we'll press clear and again enter the number 4011 and test this IC. The test is passed. So the IC is working. Now I will use an IC from 45 series. So this is 4584 IC. We will again find this IC. Auto find. So auto search is running. And let's see what it suggest us. So 4584 is our IC that I have placed in. Now press clear. 4584, that are device number that we enter. Now press test. You can use either of the test button for testing the IC. So test is passed, the IC is working. So this is about the working of this device as a digital IC tester. For seeing the working of this digital IC tester as a frequency counter in this mode, we will first turn on the IC tester device and press mode button. As I press the mode button, this is now in the frequency counting mode and showing the 0 Hz, as we do not apply any type of frequency right now. So we have a frequency generator here. I will power on this frequency generator. So this has a limitation. This will count the frequency of TTL devices of peak to peak 5 volts. This is also mentioned in the user manual, and this can be count the frequency up to 500 kilohertz. So we will give the TTL signal or a square wave signal with the amplitude of approximate 5 volts. So change this frequency in the square wave. Now amplitude of the square wave will be, will set the 5 volts, and frequency is 1 kilohertz or 1000 hertz. Now we'll connect the BNC probe to this frequency generator, and for input we will connect the BNC probe on the signal as well. So you can see on the screen this is showing 999 hertz, and the same frequency is generated from the frequency generator as well. So this is the 999 hertz. Now I will increase the frequency to 1 kilohertz to 2 or 4 kilohertz. Now the same frequency also mentioned on the frequency counter. The approximate error is plus minus 1%, and 4 kilohertz is showing on the frequency counter as well. Now we'll increase the frequency up to 100 kilohertz or 300 kilohertz. So this is 400 kilohertz frequency. The frequency counter can be easily count the frequency of 400 kilohertz. Now I will change this frequency to 500 kilohertz. So at the 500 kilohertz range, the deflection is easily can be seen, and upper from that it do not measure the accurate results. So the IC tester will work for frequency counter for frequency up to 500 kilohertz as described in this user manual as well. So you can test and check the frequency counting up to 500 kilohertz from this frequency counter. So this is all about this product. While working with this product, if you find any difficulties, you can refer the user manual, or you can contact Tutesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. Thank you.